Hello, I'm Ros Atkins from Weekend World. North Korea is one of the most secretive countries on Earth, which makes this week's Our World all the more extraordinary. Sue Lloyd Roberts has been given permission to film, but as you can imagine, the government minders were never far away.
With the last of the great dictators, lines of young pioneers on parade, a distant glimpse of a remote Politburo, and goose-stepping soldiers. North Korea is so 20th century. And yet, with nuclear weapons and at war with the South, a very real threat to the 21st. It was a rare opportunity to visit the most secretive country on Earth. But with everything stage-managed, would it be possible to find out what is really going on inside the Democratic People's Republic of Korea? Invited for the celebrations of the great leader's birthday, the founder of the country, Kim Il-sung, who, though dead, is still president. The birthday is marked by a public holiday and floral offerings, confusing to the outsider, even in this country of the bizarre.
Today is his birthday.
I realize that, and so you're giving him flowers.
Yeah, it's the,
right.
It's the whole hearts of people.
But I believe he's dead. Does this mean that you think he is a god, that he is immortal?
Yes, he is the immortal person, eternal father of our Korean people. We don't think that he passed away.
So the great leader is president for life and the afterlife, while his son, Kim Jong-il, the dear leader, is head of the ruling Korean Workers' Party and in charge of running things in this life. He recently announced that he has a son in waiting and that the hereditary communist dictatorship is set to continue. How do people live outside this city of the elite? The great leader ruled that the army should always come first, and it was fitting that we drove first to the most fortified border in the world, with our minders forever at our sides, down an empty six-lane motorway. One thing we might all envy here, the lack of private cars means no traffic jams. No peace treaty was ever agreed at the end of the Civil War in 1953, and North and South Korea are still technically at war, with a million troops from either side based along the demilitarized zone, with 30,000 Americans in between. I expected to find more tension here after the North was accused recently of sinking a South Korean naval ship, but it all looked very quiet.
It's Sunday, and we all take a rest on Sunday.
A good day to invade.
When the Americans started the war, when they invaded us in 1950, it was also a Sunday. They thought they'd sweep through the country in one day, but during the three-year war, they got a good beating. And if they try and invade again, we'll give them an even greater beating than they got in the 1950s.
At the military museum here, George Orwell would recognize the rewriting of history by the Ministry of Truth. In fact, it was North Korean troops who crossed the line in 1950 and thereby triggered a bloody war. But then Orwell also understood the need for a government to keep a people in constant fear of an enemy, to better endure hardship at home. With a population of 23 million, North Korea has a standing army of more than a million. One in 20 are in uniform. In a country desperately short of food, the army gets priority. A third of people here suffer from stunted growth. After the famine of the 1990s, they had to abandon the 5'3" minimum height required for a soldier. I asked to visit a farm to look at how the country feeds itself. And at breakneck speed, we drove past towns and villages in various stages of dilapidation. I didn't see a single tractor in the hour it took to get here to the cooperative farm, which our minders had chosen.
On the way here, we saw a lot of other villages which didn't look quite so tidy and neat and orderly and indeed wealthy. Can we visit them? Is that possible? No?
No, this was a regular village, I was told, and to prove it, we'd visit a regular home.
Wonderful. And the gentleman's medals? You wear them every day?
His friends and...
It was explained that the medals and the feast were because the head of the household was 60 today and retiring. Clearly some confusion here. I am 59, I still work on the farm, and I normally eat noodles for lunch, he announced, before returning to the script.
Thanks to the kindness of the great leader, he built civilized housing for all of us, and then made this a mechanized model farm, and we are proud of all these things.
There was not much sign of mechanization at the model farm, though a lot of effort was going into painting political slogans. When a tractor eventually drove into sight, the chief man here, Mr. Joe, appeared to be trying to hide something from the camera. He told the tractor, bearing the European Union logo, to drive away. After all, the country claims to be self-sufficient in everything, even food. Mr. Joe, even your tractor, I saw, was donated by the European Union, so the country is not surviving without aid. As was to happen time and time again, my minder refused to translate. Should I say that again? Do you not understand the question?
I can understand, but he's going
to... I'm sure Mr. Joe knows all this. It's not a surprise to him.
In the end, they negotiated an acceptable response.
We had problems for a short time, but with our own industry and output, we can produce enough crops on our own without any support from outside.
The problem he refers to was the famine of the 1990s. Pictures smuggled out of the north at the time show the horror of the disaster, which, aid agencies claim, killed up to 2 million people. Over 10 years on, the World Food Programme is still feeding people here because the country can't produce enough food and the daily government rations are not enough. From our van, we could see shop fronts and stalls and long queues. Were these the government ration distribution points, or were they the private markets which people who have money depend on to survive? Again, we weren't allowed to stop. I was getting desperate.
Mr. John, we've only got one day left here. Please, can we go to the market?
Yes, but you can have a look around, but you can't make any films.
I could go to the market, but not with a camera.
The market was bustling with activity, and the counters loaded with local produce, vegetables and meat, and from China, electrical goods, fans, cooking utensils, clothes, shoes, bags, the lot. But it's private enterprise and the government doesn't like it.
앞으로 사회주의가 완전히 승리하게 되면은 In the future, when socialism is completely victorious, these markets will disappear. For now, we will make no effort to encourage them or increase their number, and ultimately, they must disappear.
I asked to meet English-speaking students and was taken to Pyongyang University and introduced to North Korea's internal intranet.
How do you access the World Wide Web? What internet providers, what search engines do you use?
I can't directly.
Ordinary people here are forbidden access to the internet. The Dear Leader has arranged for all that they need to know to be put on a closed system.
You know what a hand grenade is, don't you?
Yes, I know.
The hand grenade was just going to blow up, but...
The spoken English among university students is very good. How do they do it?
Thanks to the great leader, Manchu Kim Jong-il, we can see British films and even American films, even though the America is our enemy. For example, The Sound of Music.
You mentioned your great leader,
yes.
And we have heard a lot about him while we have been here in Korea. What other world leaders do you admire?
I also know many other leaders, such as Stalin and Mao Zedong in China.
Stalin, Mao, you can be forgiven for asking what century they think they're living in. I came across graduates who hadn't heard of Nelson Mandela, let alone Google. But then, if you're not told, how would you know? At school, children are taught to sing a song that tells them that they have nothing to envy in the outside world and that they are the happiest people on earth. A kindergarten with its own indoor fairground. For more than a week in North Korea, they invited us to indulge in the fantasy. I think what surprised me most here was that they could believe that we would believe that what they showed us was for real. But what's happening in the rest of the country? I had to go to South Korea to find out.